EHOME to be the big boys, the stronger side. But VG Gamer Reborn manages to sneak for a drow. Are you liking this? Have EHOME got enough to deal with the drow push?
It's a very awful strategy, but the IO plus drow rangers is really solid against teams that really they want to go all in, you know?
Yep.
The stealer pops an open wounds, the drow, you want to go in, you want to pop the rage, get the kill. You get a defense, relocate, and you know the fight is more or less salvaged. You also have Beastmaster, Roar, and Swap. So there's a multitude of ways for VGR to actually save this hero.
Okay.
So I'm thinking that, you know, it's obviously all in, as all draw strategies are.
Yeah.
But there's an opportunity for VG Gaming Reborn to just end the game like the first day of 25 minutes, because that's what draw strategies do. I'm curious as to what their last pick's going to be, because I'm guessing right now they're going to need a mid, but they're going to need something that can actually either go for the full siege. You know, we saw Death Prophet actually being taken out by Reborn themselves.
Yeah. I mean, Mikasa, I'm thinking Mikasa Dragonite. There's a Timbersaw, but DK fairly good against what Elder Titan, nice against Lifestealer, Disruptor. It could be good, couldn't it?
I mean, it's not bad, but in the last series, they actually ran Queen of Pain on Mikasa, because it's kind of like his signature hero, and of course, they take out the SM, which is another. It's another kind of. Not hallmark hero, but it's a hero that VICI Gaming Reborn have been running consecutively throughout the Chinese qualifiers, and it's shown to be pretty powerful. And it's another hero that if it gets BKB, it's more or less indestructible for the same reasons that the Drill Ranger can get in the Shadow Fiend is more or less the same.
This is EHOME.
It's an gap closing hero. So,
but no one plays. It's not a popular hero.
The main issue is they need a hero that could close the gap that would play either a support or an offlane role. So they take the Tusk with the assumption that, you know, if it's Lan playing the Tusk or a friend here, you actually close the gap on the drawer, you can get in, you have multiple ways of initiating. You can defend the Tusk, you can go for a very aggressive play and try to get a quick pick. Because if EHOME take the game late, I think they will have a sizable advantage just based on composition. And VICI Gaming Reborn go for... the storm. This is going to be offlane Tusk. Old Eleven's going to be picking that up, so Lan will be playing.
So cool Tusk. Yeah, this is
I think it's fine, but I don't know about this storm.
I mean,
the storm feels very questionable to me.
It's because you get punished in lane, I guess. Well, you imagine will Tusk. Oh no, I guess because it's the offlane. He's not worried about the Tusk.
It really depends on one thing. If VG Gaming Reborn decides this dual lane mid, where they have FY just grabbing runes and keeping myself.
Oh, you think that's what they'll keep the eye on Major?
I think it would be fine if that's what they're going to do, because then it's Drow Venge, and I think that lane is really strong in its own right. I don't think they have to go aggro. We've seen it in the past throughout the qualifier, but I think this game, it's probably just going to be like Drow Venge safe, Beastmaster off lane, and then FY and Mikasa mid. And then on the side of EHOME, you're going to have a Timber mid against a dual lane was going to be a punish for that. I think that EGR might have a slight advantage here in the early to mid game.
Oh, we got a bit of lag arena.
Do we?
I'm going to go for a quick recap. Oh, I've got my predictions though. We've got to get the predictions in. Total number of player deaths by 10 minutes.
By 10 minutes?
10 minutes is an early one, isn't it?
I'd say like
6
zero.
To 10.
I'd say 0-5.
Dude, okay, you go for that.
All right.
Most Roshan kills, that's got to be.
VG.
Yeah. Total number of blink daggers. 25 minutes in.
Okay, so Beastmaster by his blink, that's 1.
Tusk, but we have about 25
so
on it.
So 0 to 2. I'd say 0.
Yeah, because it's a win, yeah.
Hey,
look at this. And he's about to get wrecked. Why not?
I mean, you said that, but they're all just kind of catching.
They come to the tower with the open wound. Like, do we want to go for this one? Yes, we do, boys. First, they're for EHOME. Tusk, good hero.
They're
hero for level 1 gangs.
Yeah, of course. Like they're level 1 significantly better than VGRs.
Nah, they won't be occurring. I don't believe in that. Do I need to reconnect? No, I think we're fine.
No, you're good.
I think we're fine. Don't look like we're getting any lagaroo, so should be good for the time being. But yeah, coming into the game, playing wise, nothing too out of the ordinary going to be happening by the looks of it. I guess the question is, Lanham, where does he stay? Does he hang around with all 11 up top?
He's just going to play Romeo.
Yeah.
Like, just walk around, see what you find. You know, if for whatever reason it is a dual lane mid here in VGR, he might be able to help out the Timber a bit.
Okay.
I think Old Chicken might suffer just because it is a strategy and they're going to double range. So I think that's the main reason why they wanted the IO in the first place, is just to make the laning phase a little bit stronger. But we'll see how things kind of shape up here. FY obviously can round. He doesn't have to stay mid if he feels like, you know, Mikasa's going to be fine. But if for whatever reason Chicken starts to get pressure or the rotation, I mean, there's always the opportunity for him to come and save.
As well, like, yeah. So old 11, he's going to be, well, by the looks of it, jungling. So he's going to go for the jungling task. And
we got a jungle Beastmaster as well.
Old land and get the levels on the other Titan up on the top lane. Oh, looks like we are a bit of car lane. I might give the old reboot.
Connecting, just let everyone know the time. Yeah, we're not missing much of anything. There's our one kill of course at a dire jungle, but since it's more or less everyone farming. Important to note that Mikasa has been crushing the first couple of waves. He is 7-1 at 1 minute into the game. And if the jungle Beastmaster on is gonna cut Tusk more out of the side of the map than old 11, just because Tusk is innately a much slower jungler. But the most important thing to keep in mind between these two heroes is that Tusk can do something in the lane, whereas Beastmaster really does things. So
yes,
it's going to be a little bit more difficult, I think, for VG guard to kind of get their footing until Yang finally does get that ultimate.
I'm going over to disrupt the pull, the mid lane matchup. You said old chicken taking a bit of a beat down and Dima 12-3 against the CS of this Timber top lane. Old Lana, I think man, a lot of trouble. He's still deep here.
He
certainly went to sleep. We'll buy him some time. No, not enough. Magic missiles back, and well, VG up. They'll pick themselves up there for the game. So bringing it to Walmart. And, Lana. I guess he went. Did he go for that warning? Was that just now? No, that was from earlier.
I think he was just trying to scout out to see if
the jungling was
doing.
Going?
Yeah, they were fighting the jungle. Maybe he wanted to try to soak a little bit of XP from the camps, but with the fly stuff and, like, missing, it was a little bit questionable, I think, to go for something like that, but regardless, he found him, so he pretty much has a good idea of what's going down. See, FY actually making that rotate towards mid. As kind of talked about, he's got Hurricane Rune bombed up, so he'll be able to keep Mikasa more or less safe. And this is an interesting dynamic here that they have with the Storm mid, because typically, you know, Timbersaw, he's gonna farm against anyone, but Storm, who is not known for winning his lane, against Timber, he can actually do very well. Because Timber has to be in melee range to be able to do any sort of harassment here like Storm. So it's like, Beachy are getting away with the greedy bit, who transitions well into the mid game. Especially when you have Drow Aura. And it's not like EHOME are directly punishing him. It's going to be down to, you know, old Olin's rotations once he's deciding to move around the map.
Alright, we'll see what he's able to achieve then. And as you said, I mean, looking back to mid lane, it's just such a polarizing story for both of them. You know, Mikasa, he's had a great time. Timber, not at all. You know, old chicken is for. But I guess there's going to be a point in this game as well, isn't it? If old chicken, the game goes on, just kind of become the, you know, the beastly timber source that we have seen in pro gaming. VGR, they don't really have a ways of killing it. Fat in timber, do they? Don't also magic.
Yeah, they have a lot of physical DPS, yeah, which is mildly concerning. The only thing that really deals with him, I think, is the storm damage, because a lot of what storm does,
yep,
is magic.
Okay.
Like overload and static remnant, even the lightning itself is magic damage. So that's gonna be their go-to. And the other thing you can is that it's pretty easy for their team to hide timber as well. Mikasa goes for the root barrier.
Yeah, indeed, with the stuff as well. Can they get themselves this kill? Looking towards F1. They get it, and well, the turnaround, the ice has come through. No, with the rotation from VGR, the aggression of EHOME, and find ourselves.
Really good start here from VGR. They realize that as long as they control the runes, allow Mikasa to have a good game, which as of right now, EHOME have yet to punish. All the left has yet to really make his progression. I guess he got the one assist.
Oh, hello, looking to go on Mikasa. He's not level 6 yet. Can he play his way out of this with the help of FY? Might be able to. The stop coming through. Gets the slip off. In comes Mr. Snowball.
That's what I was hoping to see from EHOME.
Yeah.
Just punish that storm mid. Ideally, you want to kill him at least like 2 or 3 times before level 6. Generally for VGR, that hasn't been the case. That's his first death. He's halfway to level 6.
Yep.
Once he gets the ball lightning, those kind of all snowball ganks are going to be totally ineffective. You're not going to be able to lock this hero down unless you have like the static storm. Disruptor is only level 4 right now, so it's still going to be a bit away.
Mid lane again. TP's coming back. Primakasa. Yeah, not quite level 6, so unable to get the opening. Bottom lane, pressure being put on. Ice, ice, ice. Skipping the creeps out. 37 for 6 compared to 27 for 12 off ends Drow range. So the farm's certainly going a little bit better for Lifestealer. And especially if they can get this tower hit as well. And looks like he should be able to just Trying to ward off the boars. Actually, the stomp sleep for both of them, and ice. Yeah, he'll take both. So extra bit of XP and gold. Very nice for the man's farm, and there we have it. Tower as well. Old Lanham, he'll be the one to peek the last hit though. So ice. He's gonna be giving him a severe talking to.
Yeah, I think it's overall kind of even for both teams. Clearly, VR want to have the stronger laning phase. Like you don't pick a drill ranger and not have strong lanes. So there is marksmanship aura up and available, so it's giving the 28 bonus damage to the entire team. Even at this stage, you can start to see pushes coming out.
I think I'm gonna try and reconnect that again, Andy. Okay. Because I've got no lag. Why have I got lag?
Мощные силы света на центральной линии атакуют.
Башню сил тьмы на верхней линии атакуют. We're not missing anything.
Yeah, there's no kills that have happened. It's
oh, we're good.
Everyone farming.
Oh, we're good. We got a good shot. Oh, no. Did you stop moving? I did that back. No, we're good. Did it. We're good.
We did it.
We beat this great firewall of China. No, we haven't. And this is beautiful. Oh, that was a good reconnect. That feels good. Yeah, we didn't miss anything. Still pretty static. Oh, what was our prediction in terms of kills? You said 5-10 minutes. Oh, it's still in the 0-5 region.
Yep.
You're close. You are doing well. Let's just see how if this movement goes well. Man, if I'm a castle, they're not going to come around here. Hang on. Old Lanham has ice in him. We've seen it so many times. It's 7 minutes in. The China sides, they love to get their carry involved in the action. They really do. I'll see if they find an opportunity for that. And we'll see as well if EGR expects, if they do expect Life Seed to be up there. Obviously, they'll see us off the map. Fenrir, we give the down block to try and get him up to that six static. And the reaction for VGR. Cast is going over at the back of the FY. What are you trying to lead in? But the snowball straight into the Drow Ranger. Come on, Foy's coming along. Trying to end the line, but he's going to have the time. But the check went slow. The Pontus move. Ends going to get taken down. FY. Well, they'll find themselves a second. EHOME, old chicken with the double kill. DDC teeping themselves straight away. No quarter, no way can cancel that. But there we have it. The lifestealer bomb caught him off guard. Old 11's Tusk, it's working out. He's been in every kill so far.
It's something that they desperately need with their lineup. So when they were down to their last pick, they needed a hero that could force the engagement.
Yeah.
And there wasn't really anything left because they had a Trissa that was going to be going mid. So they couldn't pick Queen, they couldn't pick Puck. They had to get a hero that had some like jungling capabilities and could also just say, we're fighting right here and right now. So Tusk just seemed to alleviate all the problems that their draft had for EHOME up until that point. And, you know, Spar has been working out.
A bomb for Kassa with the haste room, ready to go for it. Fenrir's being spotted out, static storm, I mean, he dropped around, and that means Kassa can't get the initial. Oh, chicken with the TP. Can they actually find anything in return? That's the question. Well, they're looking to move it onto Yang, but Yang turns around with the roar. Onside, side, Gust as well. It's going to come before the Rage Wearer's off guard. No, he's not going to be fine. Magnum is up on the igloo. It's not enough to trap him. Oh, chicken around with the burst, but EHOME, they've already lost two. Tower hits onto Yang. Can he de-aggro? Where's the de-aggro? It's not there. Yang taken down by the tower. They'll lose one in return. But VCR looking to move in for more. Magic missile onto Old Chicken to find themselves a third. Double kill for Mikasa. The snowball across the tree line as Old 11 trying to escape. But they're looking to chase it down. Zipping forward, can Mikasa get the connection? He can. It flows there from the overload. One more touch, they'll do it. A fourth kill for VGR. Fantastic fight for them there, down on the bottom lane.
Man, they are just going all there. Even going to see them maybe continue a little bit more. FY taking some damage here. Looks like they'll be able to tether to end and be just fine. But the damage output that VGR have at this stage in the game is nuts.
I mean, look at this. 9 minutes in, a storm that's 3-1-2. You don't see that on a storm spray every day.
Yeah, but it's all due to the fact that he has a Wisp.
Yes.
He's been coming to his lane, yeah, making sure that he's having a good laning phase. A ranged hero. He'll just farm. You know, it's like playing a Zeus mid. Both heroes just farm in the matchup. So, that being said, Storm is happy with trading the farm because during the mid game, his initiation potential and the kind of way he scales into the mid late game is going to just be more valuable than what a Timber brings. So, EHOME kind of finding themselves in a bit of a pinch here. Obviously, there's a lot more Dota to be played, so there's a chance for EHOME to make a way back into this, but for right now, VGR seem to be kind of hitting all the timings.
I really do indeed. Mid lane, Kassa, tethered up by FY, Yang getting a lot of space up top. As EHOME have three mid, Old 11 joining the crew, they'll smoke up, they want to look for some action. With the snowball, see what they can find, they may catch Mikasa going down. rune. Let's just have enough control. They do have a static storm. They might have to pop it and they will. They want to get this kill and they should do. The control off the disruptor. It's enough. Oh, a splitter to the face as well. No messing from EHOME as they take down that kill. And it's a good kill as well.
I mean, he got the rune.
I guess he did.
Yeah, he got the regen. Worth it.
We'll see if he can work some magic with that when he's back. That's arguably, yeah, the best rune to have on the storm split.
Yeah, it's definitely up there. I mean,
DD at this stage as well. It means a lot.
It's very solid. So, the way the game's kind of shaping up, VGR are still well on their way into hitting that timing. You know, N just finishes up his Dragon Lance right now. They can start going for the CT. At 11 minutes, I would actually say that it might be a tiny bit behind in regards of towers, because even the offlane tier 1 is still standing. But I think that's also because EHOME, you know, they sent 4 heroes up at like, you know, 7 minutes or 8 minutes, and they decided to go for a kill on end at that stage. So they realized that stopping the momentum of EGR as soon as humanly possible is how they win this game. Because if they transition later on, you know, EHOME during the mid game, they have this Timber who's clearly going to be a big threat as well. But it's interesting to me because the Storm kind of, it throws a wrench in EHOME's plans, because normally at Drow Strat, you would just say it falls off so hard at a certain point, like post 30 minutes, that you would probably just say that EHOME would win. But Storm is that hero who just adds the X factor, you know, the pickoff potential, and how much damage he can do with the marksmanship, the extra damage with a True Shadow Run. Excuse me. What's that next? Could be in trouble.
And then the static storm set up. Oh, the glimpse! Oh, if he lives! Oh, no! Oh, he jukes out the Thunderstrike down through the double zap!
He's got the regen.
Oh, that's not the combo you're looking for as the disruptor.
Oh god, that was actually so unfortunate. If he waited even one more second,
then he would have been still in the ring, yeah.
Yeah, he would have been dead for sure. That is a very big opportunity miss here for EHOME. Killing that storm after the laning phase and just stopping him from getting that orchid. That is huge for them.
Oh, Venom's gonna walk to the caster. He's got the DD. I don't know who you're talking about that he loves to have. Zippy zap, but the snowball comes out. The central shot is working for EHOME. The control, but the silence is amazing. Comes in. Not the Drow Ranger. Not gonna be enough, but they've lost two already. Ice Ocean coming in the middle of it all. And he goes for the TP out, but there's 5 heroes being down on him. VGR once again. I mean, it's just the decision making from EHOME just hasn't been top notch, and VGR outplaying them every time.
I mean, this is a Roshan too. That's the other problem, is because of the fact they do have this Beastmaster, and they have the Precision Aura, they can just go for Roche at any given point. There's only one hero on the side of each hero that's not ranged, and of course it is Beastmaster. He's almost got his book one, he's gonna have it after this Roshan goes down. Even though VGR haven't really taken the towers, they still have a tremendous amount of problem on all three of their cores. Like, Yang is still sitting at 69 creep kills in a 13 minute game. This is like a jungle slash offlane Beastmaster, and they're already looking to start pushing towers at 13 minutes in. Sure, they haven't taken a tier 1, but they have all the momentum in the world. Like, team fights like that, when you're playing this type of strategy, you take the entire map away from your opponent.
I mean, look at the Macass as well. The Storm Spirit. He is building towards the Orchid first. Why the Orchid first before the Bloodstone that we see most Storm Spirits being
Orchid
picked up?
Orchid with Drow Aura is, it's like, just, it's insane.
Yeah.
Like, he gets a bonus 42 damage right now. That's pretty much like having a Demon Edge.
Yeah.
And your inventory. So if he has an Orchid, he solo kills any hero on the side of EHOME, maybe barring Ice, because the toggling can more than likely keep you in. But now VGR.
Oh, hello Yang. He's maybe around a little bit too long. Here come the TP reactions. They'll jump straight away on the Beastmaster. Gets the roar up on Gold Chicken Beef at 5. Trying to look for some kind of save. It's not going to work. The snowball, ball on ball action. Ayo's popped as well. The captain's turned up. Zip zapping forward. But he goes straight to the static storm. EHOME. There's a full 5. This time it's VG Reborn making the mess up. They'll lose Mikasa. He's got the Aegis head. Trying to TP out. The Echo stops there in time. Can Mikasa save himself in this one? Looking for the Zip Zap Zoo. They're already trying to close him off. Trying to chase him down. But the Lord Mana EHOME. Mikasa himself. Oh, he went for the TP Zip Zap. Smart plays from Mikasa, keeps himself alive, but overall EHOME happy with the outcome of that one. 3 heroes down and the Aegis popped as well.
Where was the Venge?
Hello.
Like, that was just total miscommunication from VGR. They were pushing into the tier 2, and they say, okay, well, we have the Aegis advantage on our Storm. We could probably take this engagement, but the fact that there was no defensive swap means that as soon as they go on somebody, they're just dead. So instead of being able to, you know, potentially swap out Mikasa on the first death, he just dies because he's under the static storm. And then after that point, the rest of the team dies in the meantime because Snowball comes out from old 11. So I don't know if that's just on the Venture not being there, or the fact that the breakdown in communication, you know, DDC not saying, hey, I'm not here, please wait like 20 more seconds before you decide to fight, and EHOME with a huge defense.
Absolutely, and then defense that needed, I think we see on the graph, indeed, there was a kind of a 4-5k lead, now it swung back around. You know, by no means a massive difference, as we can see, you know, one team fight this stage of the game will, you know, resurrect any kind of position that a team's been pulling down to. And VGR, they're looking to regain that one. They're smoked up, moving them around over to the Radiant side of the map. See what they can do here at the same time. EHOME in a very defensive posture, they're going to smoke up themselves. Lifestealer getting himself deep inside the Centaur Conqueror. And they'll look to lead the way with that one. They're looking to get a nice stomp. They'll come up to the high ground. Scant coming out from the Dire. They know that they're here. They know there's a smoke on smoke action. Ball's been dropped down. They'll see the Centaur. They'll wonder if there's something fishy going on. FY finding in position on the side. Where's the jumping going to be? Well, it's to the ice side. Going on to FY. Takes him out. The captain zips into the middle of the fight. The ball's coming. She's there. And they beat him down. Standing to the man. They'll find it. Raw. On the ice side. There's the He keeps himself alive, the only toggle! Lifestealer's gonna live at EHOME! Moving in for more, they're down two! They're gonna look towards Yang, zip tapping forward, the old chicken with the chakra finds the third! Red DDC on the retreat, but the kinetic field's down! The swap, he tries to dodge the stop, but he will, but he's not gonna be able to dodge the end of his life! Snowball to the backside, EDC taken down, and EHOME, with the last two fights under their belt, they're regaining that strength that we expect to see from EHOME, a team tipped to be the hottest in China at the moment.
Oh, that was just a disaster. Did FY get stunned? He must have, because he had tether that entire time and he didn't try to get out after ISSI started going on him. So, you know, back to back, two fights where VGR just get routed, more or less, and that's going to be really good for EHOME because a Jorospichi typically wants to hit their stride roughly like, you know, 25 minutes. That's when they're at their most powerful. And then all of a sudden, it's just.
Going on here, Andrew!
Yo, Crimson's fine.
Is it?
Yeah. I mean, okay.
I mean, he's not dying, is he?
Think about this, right? Beast.
Yep.
Then there's Necronomicon, which is more physical damage. Then you have Ventura. Then you have Precision Orb. He needs to be able to frontline and also deter the enemy from trying to attack him. So reactive armor plus Crimson for his whole team is that their team is entirely physical damage.
Okay.
The Storm is the only person who does any magical DPS whatsoever. So against 4 out of 5 of the heroes of GR, it's more than okay.
Alright. Some tasty stuff.
Yeah.
From the chicken.
You can't just walk around with only a Crimson and be happy with,
yeah.
Like, your mana expenditure is going to outweigh your regen by a long shot until you get at least one item.
Be able to finish up this tier 1 here in the mid lane. Old Chicken as he clears out of the way. No reaction for VGR. They'll put the fortification, but not looking to fight at this stage again. And coming forward, just poking his head in. He's trying to build towards... Is this going to be an SMY or is this Yasha then BKB?
I would probably say BKB.
Yeah. Oh, well, that's not a trick.
I think SNY is... It's not really helpful for Dro in this game, because if you have SNY and you get jumped on by the Tusk or the Lifestealer, it's not like the extra movement speed health from that item is going to save you. Like, Home will kill you even if you have a little bit of extra health, but if you have a BKB, you can just walk away from the open wounds. You don't have to worry about Killer Titan Stomp, you don't have to worry about Snowball Stun or Glimpse or any of that nonsense, so... I think that's probably going to be the item. In the meantime, looks like Storm finishes up his Orchid. And even though this timing, you know, truth be told, is pretty late for Mikasa, given the fact that he was doing very well mid, he has died 3 times. So I think now he needs to just go, like, directly into BKB and hope that his initiation can kind of tilt the fights and VGR's favor. I think they're just going to struggle in that game.
Pings onto mid lane. They'll make it close. And they got the glims. And in a lot of trouble. And he goes down. We'll trap him. FY immediately with the save. Takes him out. Now, FY will almost step over his left on the way back. He may look to try and tether across, but yeah, he's going to have the tether available. No, they've got him. Oh, no, they...
That was a bit comical, but in the meantime, yeah. They kill the offlane tier 1.
They did, well, so. And they killed the tier as well. I was looking to defend this.
Yeah.
Tibble was up there, they're punishing.
All in all, a good trade for VGR. That's 3-2.
Yeah, I still managed to get a nice pace here on his farm.
Yeah, this still, you know, it's still doable for VGR, but they're kind of running out of time, I feel. Lifestealer will eventually reach this kind of like critical mass where he'll just be able to go on somebody and kill them, you know, force swap or whatever, force will relocate. And Beastmaster Roar is nice and everything, but you still have to worry about the damage output of the Timber Saw. Static Storm on Fenrir is pretty scary, Earth Splitter. EHOME just have a very well-rounded draft.
Kill the boss. Do they have any smokes? Who's got the smokes? No smokes at the moment. Just a straight up movement towards the top. See what they can do. Rip port. Trying to close in. Oh no, Mikasa's out of that. Still, FY in the neighborhood. He's been left by DDC, FY alone. But it'll be fine. Sells himself off to the east. The push still coming in from EO. Three heroes towards the top. Eyeing up that tier one. Fairly low at the moment, so they can certainly look to finish it off with this push. Now, ice, 300 got away from the Desolator.
I'm kind of wondering if... You know, VG clearly want the next Roshan. That's kind of what you do, as Dire Draw Strats, is you just kill Roshan over and over again, and then just start running on lanes and hope that your Aegis kind of carries it by having two lives in the storm. They haven't even killed the mid-tier one, and it's 21 minutes in. There's a Solar Crest on 11. So between the Crimson and the Solar Crest,
yeah.
Like, they understand that the biggest threat that VGR have is the ability to kill somebody inside of a Beastmaster Roar. So because they don't have a traditional save, like an Avenge Swap or something like that, or an Oracle Ultimate, they're itemized so that their cores have an opportunity to live via Crimson, Activate, and then also having the Solar Crest on them. Because at that point, you have less evasion, lots of armor, damage mitigation from the Crimson. And then you can turn the fight based on the idea that they want to focus down one person. They park pretty much on the side of VGR. So I think that the way that they're playing this out is more or less perfect. Like, they understand what they need to do.
Yeah. Absolutely. Roshan back up 45 seconds. We'll see how they're able to play around that both sides. Overall net worth difference. It's bang zero at the moment.
Yeah, this game is insanely close. Still anyone can take this. Yeah. Still probably a bit more pressure on VGR.
Yeah, for sure. The fact is, you see, they just haven't got as much momentum as maybe they would have hoped to get this with the Drow Draft. And yeah, Drow BKB now as well. So this is going to help end a lot. Positioning has been pretty good in the fights. He has been taken out three times, but at the same time, we've seen him get a fair bit of damage. Yeah. He's only really gone down in those last couple of fights where VG just have lost it. And he's been the last one stand, as obviously not a lot he can do himself. To keep himself alive without FY and the crew around.
Got a little bit of Kali going on, but
we're good.
Roshan's gonna respawn. I have a feeling that contesting this for EHOME isn't actually gonna be that difficult because they had Elder Titan. I think Elder Titan and Tusk are probably, you know, two of the better Roshan contention heroes in game. Just because you can throw a spirit out, and by having it inside a pit, the rest of each yard are like, okay, well, if we get slept, it could potentially be like a 3 or 4-man Earth Splitter. And then we have to just back out, so... Next area of contention, most likely going to be that Roche. It's pretty being circled up here by Fenrir. Then you also have to take into account that VGR do have Beastmaster Vision.
Oh, the question is, how do they play around this? Yeah. They know that they are going to have eyes in at VGR, and they're... Yeah, they're gonna go for the spot, but they're gonna go for a spot.
I like this.
They need to find a kill first. If they find at least one kill,
they don't.
They're going deeper. They might settle
for
him.
I mean, there we go.
Yeah, they'll just settle straight in. Goodbye, FY. And immediately onto the Roshan. Yeah. At the same time, Kassa putting pressure in on top. Continuing to just go for the Roshan. And he should find this two mid on his own. So. VGR, they are finding something in return, and they may even just try and contest Roshan. DDC and Mikasa are smoking up, they're going to start to move in. Roshan down to half health, there'll be a little bit of a chance for them to try and do something sneaky. Let's see, let's go down. With the Hawking for Vision, buyback from FY. Let's see what goes on. Wave of Terror coming through the silence, onto the mall, jumping in. The Static Storm's there in reaction, and puts the beat getting up to the side, trying to keep ice, for the Crimson Guard. It's doing a lot of work, ice, keeps himself low, gets pressure down to block 3, EHOME, they're going to lose 4, Fenrir could have on the sidelines as well. VGR, they'll take the Roshan, Yak picks up the Aegis, and picks up 4 kills as well, only losing Mikasa. What a Roshan fight for VGR.
Man, Yang carried that so hard. Okay, he roars ice. He's like the majority of the damage to Roshan. That's the most important part.
Okay, so he turns to Roshan, just
Yeah, because as soon as he roars a lifestealer, that pretty much means that EHOME can't kill Roman.
Ooh, let's make it a 2-1.
Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. Old Lanham. That was perfect execution though from Yang. And honestly, the fact that he has, like, Blink 3 at this stage in the game with 2100 gold in his inventory as well.
And again, there's been the chaotic as well.
Yeah. No, that was very good. FY only had like 5 seconds on his respawn. They understood that he needed to buy back.
And now we'll see if EHOME can get the punish. TP's in immediately. Trying to close the gap. Oh, JK is already. Oh, he's got up the Crimson Guard. Who's back onto Yang. Gonna pull through Yang in trouble. He turns, starts to beat down on Tyson on the back line. TPC being focused by all the left. Draw coming through Yang again. Who in his best to set it up for this? They'll find themselves a Fenrir kill. They're looking towards Old Chicken. They're all found three here. They may find themselves a fourfold chicken. He's all doing themselves. Kind of chip. Now, they're with the Dustin Lines because the first step is flicked in. Chucks out the axe. Can they do it? Yes, they can. VGR, Mikasa, Mikasa. And again, VGR are just destroying EHOME at this stage.
Man, that was so brutal for EHOME. And the thing is, VGR have amazing high potential. Beastmaster Aura, Precision Aura, they have the Dragon Lance on the draw already. This is just like two catastrophes back to back. And all that, keeping in mind that they also have a Storm. He's going for the Bloodstone now, he's not actually rushing for the BKB. Probably feels pretty confident after the Roshan.
Wait, he's got the Bloodstone? He's got the Bloodstone done.
Yeah, he's got a ton of farm. This is a good spot for VGR. Like, Yang is just...
Look at that Worth as well. Just look at this. I mean, I know Old 11's been having a good game on the Tusk, but I mean, I size at Old 11 at the same bit. That's not good news for the Lifestealer.
It's honestly just Yang. Like, the fact that he has so much money at this stage in the game, you know, you put Old 11 on this Tusk and he's supposed to have like a really big impact during the laning phase. He only really ganked once. You know, like, he went mid, he killed Mikasa the one time, and that's fine, but during the big fights that matter, like the Roshan engagement and fighting top lane, killing Ice again, even though Yang maybe uses Roar a bit, you know, overkill, it's still killing the biggest damage potential on EHOME.
Oh, Ice, goodbye!
See you later.
What a play. And now Old 11, he's in trouble as well, he tries to roll in at the top. He's gonna come out, but not in time, and Mikasa's hit forward, he's looking for more already, trying to go on Fenrir. Fenrir drops the static still, Mikasa, he's already out of it, he'll find Fenrir as well, now giving it for more, Mikasa's not... from Yang, Roar on your old chicken, the wave of Terran's there, the physical damage is going to send a rip through the Dimasaur, pulling it in, silencing him up, and off the hold the ocean there, we'll take down one, but he's got an Aegis Yang, he's going to be back for more, and VGR just playing out of their minds at this point, and EHOME, they just don't know what hit him.
Man, this is just... Yang MVP, definitely MVP for this game. That's going to be an easy set of racks for VGR, they're going to wait towards bottom lane.
They're going to get a second.
There's no buyback.
There's no fortification.
No. Should be two racks easy. Oh, the Stomp might actually delay it enough. But the Disruptor doesn't have Static Storm. So even if Fenrir respawns.
What a beatdown here from Vizia.
It escalated very quickly.
It really did. And in a game as well where it's even and kills. Well, here we go. This is the fun of turn. Jumping in. Raid. And a... DDC will find themselves to kill on the end. Now the DDC is the backline. Mikasa zipping in for the other time kill. This defensive yield uses him sometimes. Oh no. Mikasa still finishes it off, jumps in onto Ice. Right, and it's all but over. It's all but over. GG is called. And in a series where a lot of people would have tipped EHOME to be the big dogs coming in from the higher half, VGR are just. They're just absolutely destroying.
I mean, we're starting to see why so many people in this region are banning Gro in the first two. I would not put it past EHOME to just take that hero out in the second game, unless they have first pick, in which case, you know, they might try to do something similar themselves. But, you know, it didn't really look that bad for EHOME, like the first 15-20 minutes, they were forcing some pretty good engagements.
It looked alright. And Tusk, 11, I was having a great time, it was like 4-1-11 or something ridiculous.